Hello everyone, how are you doing on this fine Wednesday? Do you remember when a while back, in early battle against headbanging Ludicolo, I mentioned that I'm making a core of my new team? Well, this is what came out of it, and today it's gonna be put to the test in the battle against Epic Kyogre 78, who was claiming to be playing RU a lot, and he was also testing a new team. So are you ready? Let's get into it. So this is one of these battles which look like they have a few turns missing and start from somewhere in the middle, because there are no Stealth Rocks, no Scouting, Turn 1, Galvantula, Life Orb Thunder? Nope, not quite enough. Entei, Life Orb Flare Blitz, see you in a different life. So after this spectacular intro, it's like the battle begins only now. I go to my Scarfed Rotom, because bearing Scarfed Chinchino and Shadow Sneak from Gallade, it's gonna outspeed everything on my opponent's team, giving me a handy scouting ability. However, looking on his team, I'm almost certain that Clefable is gonna be a specially defensive supporter set, because otherwise Chinchino doesn't make much sense on the same team. That is why I decide to risk it and go for a trick right away, predicting it, and for once I do get it right, and this thing being crippled right on the start is gonna make my life a lot easier. I switch to my Gallade as he decides to lock himself on a Toxic, which isn't actually that bad at all, because I'm not planning on setting up for a sweep this time, and it prevents his Sigilyph from burning me, and speaking of Sigilyph, here it comes. But I go for a taunt on his switch, which if he's running the most common set, shuts him down completely. Knowing that, I go to my Sandslash to set up a Stealth Rock, because with no Rapid Spinner on his team, they are gonna help in weighing down his Chinchino, which is at this point the biggest threat to my team. On the same turn, however, he goes to Dweeble for the same reason, but I Rapid Spin his Rock immediately as he just throws in the threat. Now, although Bullet Seed is painfully obvious, I know that unless he's Bandit, I can take one, and I need to get some damage off on this thing, so that he can't freely switch it in and out. That is why I decide to stay in and go for an Earthquake, which joined with Stealth Rock damage and Life Orb recoil ensures that he will not survive the next Stealth Rock switch in. However, because he isn't locked on any move, I really don't want to risk switching to my Skiter on a predicted Rock Blast, so I decide to stay in, knowing that he'll go down to a Life Orb recoil, and he just goes for a Bullet Seed again, so we end up with another double down. Now though that I no longer have my Rapid Spinner, I know that the first thing he's gonna try is to set up his Rocks again, so I decide to prevent that from happening by bringing my Bandit Skiter, and thanks to my own Rocks breaking his 30 on the switch, Aerial Ace takes him out in one hit. Now back comes Sigilyph, and knowing that he can take one hit from me, I go to my specially defensive Lapras, because I don't really mind getting burned, and if he tries to set up Cosmic Powers, I can just roar him out of there, and that's exactly what I end up doing. His Clefable gets dragged out, and because of the choice cards I've given him earlier, his move choice basically comes down to either Toxic or a Seismic Toss, so I figured that the safest option is to just go back to Gallade. Then, knowing that he's not gonna stay in locked on a Toxic, I go for a Taunt in case he goes back to Sigilyph, but he decides to bring his own Gallade instead. Seeing that he's holding Leftovers, I'm thinking that he might be running Bulk Up set as well, in which case he probably doesn't want to stay in and let me set up in his face, so I switch to my Rotom, predicting him to go back to Sigilyph, but it turns out to be a bit different variant, he stays in and goes for a Psycho Cut on my switch. It does exactly 130 HP, so with help of Leftovers that I took from Clefable, I know that Shadow Sneak won't be enough to take me out, so I just go for a safe Shadow Ball, but he predicts that and goes right back to Clefable to take it. Still, knowing that he can't do anything other than toxicking me, I decide to stay in and go for a Thunderbolt for a bit of damage to make sure that Skiter will be able to finish him off later on, and considering that he's more than likely specially defensive, it does a solid chunk, so Rotom is putting some heavy work for a team, especially that now he goes to Sigilyph, probably thinking that I'm gonna switch out because of toxic damage, and straight out dies to a Thunderbolt. Normal Rotom people, do not underestimate this thing. So now I know that all I need to win is to bring my Skiter, and although he gets the double Protect Off, it doesn't change the fact that he has nothing left to take a Bandit Technician boosted Aerial Ace, so that is the game. Good game, Epic Kyogre. I'm honestly pretty happy with this team, so you can certainly expect to see it again. But for now, rate, comment, and I see you all next time.